We were in the middle of February and winter still had its grip on us. We were given a few sunny days. Those sunny days were then again followed by cloudy and snowy days. While Craig kept taking care about the driveway, my job was to clear the deck. I focused on progression, not perfection. We kept sustaining ourselves throughout the long and everlasting winter by nurturing our bodies and souls with home-cooked meals and family dinners. In spite of the fact that we do enjoy our life in the middle of Alaska, and I particular the winters, we realized it was time for change.
Hey guys, how's it going? So the last video you saw was Alex with her ski thing. That's not really my thing. So this next video we're gonna show you is more my thing. I grew up in a big city, well, kind of a big city, just medium size, Birmingham, Alabama. But I got used to being in cities. The Army kind of showed me this place and I have grown to like it, but I do sometimes miss the big city and all the things you can do there and go and see. So we're gonna go on a little trip to a big city, not so far away.
Logan, are you sad that we are leaving? We'll be back. Mm-hmm. We decided to take Friday off and to extend our weekend. That day, we drove to the Fairbanks Airport that is so conveniently located just 5 miles or approximately 8 kilometers from town. Prior to that, we came to the conclusion that we needed a change of scenery and booked a flight to Anchorage, a short flight of only an hour. We made it to Anchorage around 10 o'clock in the morning, got into our rental car and started driving. Craig and I love to drive through neighborhoods and look at houses. Lucky us, we were greeted with some snowfall and some overcast, and by this little one. After our house sightseeing tour, we headed towards downtown, passing the Fairbanks headquarters. It is a winter festival held annually. Fairbanks refers to the Fair Rendezvous Festival. It derives from swap meets at which fur trappers would gather to sell their winter harvest. In early Anchorage, this took place in mid-February. Over the years, it evolved into a festival to bring the community together and now also became one of our premier sprint dog races. We kept strolling through downtown, visited some art galleries, passed along some Alaskan-themed wall murals, and then headed to the mall, mainly just for window shopping and then also to get a bite to eat because it was lunchtime. After lunch, we walked a few more steps, visited another art gallery, and found the 49th State Brewing Company, located downtown. Besides beer, they are also offering a menu with freshly sourced Alaskan products. They have a rooftop patio overlooking the Cook Inlet and the Alaska Range.
That was good. We go back over here. I did try the
Blonde Eagle Ale.
Okay, one more time. Because you've tasted some of these too. That's a winner.
How about the other two?
I noticed nobody really touched these. Okay, here we go. That is a, what is it?
Nitro McCarthy Stout.
McCarthy. Well, I do have some memories of trying to go to McCarthy. Couldn't get down the road. So let's see if I can get this down. Kind of like the road, can't get it down. this is pretty rough stuff. Just like the road to McCarthy. Okay, and this is
smoke lager. Oh, like barbecue.
Okay, like barbecue. That tastes like barbecue. It's just pure. You know that smell when you scrape the grill? That's what I'm getting here. So that'll stay right inside that little slot. But that's the end of the taste test there. I'm gonna stick with this down on this end.
So. Our hotel check-in time was not until 4 o'clock. So we still had some time to pass until then. We took the time because the weather was not that great and decided to check out some more stores. This one I'm familiar with living in Germany. It's a Swedish store. Sometimes it is just nice to see things we know from home. And then we finally made it into the hotel, rested a little bit, and then walked to dinner.
Thank you.
next morning, we took our time and then went to breakfast. We tried to get a glimpse of the Chugach mountain range. Unfortunately, it was still too cloudy. But Craig was as happy as he could be because he found one of his favorite childhood stores.
Place as a little kid in Birmingham, Alabama, many, many years ago. Still love it today.
You happy now?
Yes, ma'am. Can you open the trunk?
No, you have the key.
Oh, do I? Oh. See the thing about donuts. Can't remember nothing.
So we are at the Cook Inlet and on our way back to the airport. Unfortunately, it's super cloudy and not a good visibility, so you cannot see much other than the ice. That's the Cook Inlet. I think it's called the neck arm, one of those tighter areas of the Cook Inlet. And for us, it's time to go back home.
By the Anchorage, head back to Fairbanks. It's a nice little trip.
Time. Plane is delayed, so we make the best out of it.
And then the plane got even more delayed, and we stayed a little bit longer in Anchorage than we had anticipated.
Well, this is the Philly cheesesteak pizza, so check this out. I ordered that thing. It was probably the oddest thing on the list, on the menu. So it's a why not check it out? See what it tastes like. Most traditional pizza, pepperoni. Yeah, go figure, that's Alex. Go with what's safe sometimes. No, get out there and do something different. Y'all take care. Tonight's side dish, fried mushrooms, and fried bell peppers. Should be pretty good.
And as you can see, we are back home. We made it safely back from Anchorage, and I think we both agree that there is no better place than home. Also, it was really nice to be in a bigger city and just walk through the busy streets and through all the shops and stores. It is just always nice being back home where it is quiet and peaceful.
Take care of yourself and your loved ones, sending love and peace from Alaska. And thank you so much for all of your continuous support. If you like this video, please subscribe and hit the like button.